Neorealism was an answer by Italian filmmakers to years of oppression in white telephoto films, telling stories not prevalent to the lives of the people. Before World War II, the film industry was strictly controlled by the Italian government, overseeing all cinematic operations in Italy. Its main goal was to promote the making of educational films and documentaries to raise awareness of the link between film and politics. After the war, however, with destroyed environments and limited resources, filmmakers had to change their style and began relying on filmmaking techniques which became the conventions of neorealism, which modern filmmakers implement due to their effect on the representation of reality. The focus of the studies of two such films have been molded by the Italian neorealism movement, A Separation by Farhadi and Roma by Cuarón, comparing the depictions of family dynamics in neorealist films through the technical aspects and film theories reflected in them. Both Farhadi's A Separation and Roma by Cuarón can be classified as films of counter-cinema due to them conveying everyday lives instead of the unrealistic stories in the films of Hollywood. Counter-cinema, proposed by Claire Johnson, states that the narratives include characteristics which include foregrounding, requiring audiences to perceive and comprehend a movie actively, unpleasure, which aims to change spectators, and betraying the reality of cultural expectations. This is done throughout A Separation in Roma, which I will look at further in the study. Italian screenwriter Cesare Zavattini states that due to this causing of an unconscious mistrust in reality, we must have a real interest in what is happening, which is why cinema must recruit living souls, not simply the rich. This concept has influenced Iranian cinema by the techniques of Italian neorealism due to the similar nature of their stories. The origins of neorealism stem from a Marxist background. It was Cesare Zavattini who said, "I believe in imagination, but I have more faith in reality, in people. I am not interested in prearranged encounters, in the drama of things that happen to come together, influencing the narrative of his films." Torin Holland from the Johns Hopkins University Press states that Cesare Zavattini's apparently antithetical vision of a cinematic chronicle tends rather towards de-dramatized and ambiguous hit and new, which is Latin for here and now, which is prominent in his screenplay of Umberto D. He believes that Zavattini utilizes Marxist teachings and rooted them to film through neorealism. Neorealist films tend to be about political clashes and class struggles due to their socialist origin. The representation of family dynamics lends itself to neorealism, as families tend to be a large part of an individual's life, allowing neorealism to expose the lives of the characters through their interactions. Asghar Farhadi grew up in the wake of the 1979 Islamic Revolution led by Islamic organizations and student movements, later influencing the Green Movement of 2009, which was a political movement often portrayed in the mise-en-scene of A Separation. The color green is present throughout the film, most notably in the kitchen, a setting often used in film to portray feminine oppression. However, in A Separation, the women lash back and fight expectations such as Simin standing up for her progressive ideologies, or Termeh teaching her father how to use the washing machine. The conservative ideologies are shown through the use of white, a color associated with the state, the father, and the little girl. Similarly, Alfonso Cuarón grew up during the Dirty War, which was driven by the class and racial division. Cuarón was a child when student movements who rose up against the government were massacred, an event that was loosely portrayed in Roma. Cuarón didn't want a film that looks vintage, that looks old. He wanted to do a modern film that looks into the past, which is why he opted for a black and white scheme, a common neorealist convention. Through the composition of shots, there is a sense of division between the state and its people, with the camera looking down upon them as a point of view shot. Simon and another, while placed next to each other, are shown to be detached, a reflection upon the conflicting viewpoints looking up at the state, who is established as the authoritative figure. This sense of detachment is prevalent in Roma, with Cleo lurking amongst the family. It can be derived from the visit to Cleo's village as she is of lower class background, and due to the power structures determined by the hegemony of society, a theory stated by Italian philosopher Antonio Gramsci in Cademia del Carte, she will never fit in as she is regarded as an outsider looking down upon by the hierarchy of the family, which is the father. The characters in Roma are personas of ideology set in society, with those in higher class, age, and male regarded as authoritative figures, seen through the dominant character blocking. This is because ideologies contain an element of knowledge of reality, however, from its inception, is a deformed and falsified system of reality, according to Marta Harnecker. A Separation also depicts the men looking down on the woman, as such in this scene, which shows Nader obscuring as Razia's path and is framed to be taller due to his higher status. Marta Harnecker states that human beings are found effectively determined by objective structures, which places men higher up in the power structures due to them being the financial providers of a family. However, in this scene, this idea is challenged with Razia being framed above the father, who should supposedly be of higher status, yet is outcasted due to his Alzheimer's disease, being isolated from society. One of the most notable scenes in Roma is a long take which remains in constant motion in the beginning of the film. This establishing shot of the family dynamics shows Cleo lagging behind, struggling to keep up with the family's demands as the long take, a neorealist convention, can utilize character blocking as she is often placed all over the frame instead of being centralized. This detached nature of the family is also prevalent in A Separation. In this establishing shot where Simon and Nader arrive from court, The men and women are separated, shown in the mise-en-scene through the use of glass as a divider. There is also a sense of class division as the maid and her daughter are placed lower in the frame. The constant reframing, blocking, and motion of the establishing shot help lay the foundations of the family dynamics without stating it directly by means such as dialogue. While the hierarchy hasn't been accepting of Cleo, the children are shown to have done so due to the progressive ideologies of class equality. However, they lack a say in the matter. The lighting and shading in the scene, as well as the character blocking, places Leo in the background. As she walks behind the family, there's very little lighting on her, which places less emphasis, yet as she joins the children in watching the film, the lighting changes to match the foreground, making Cleo brighter. Neorealism commonly utilizes diegetic lighting. The light brightening Cleo is the television, done to emphasize Cleo's acceptance. The use of glass as an indication of division is constant throughout a separation. It shows how men and women are separated due to the roles imposed by ideological structures of society, with the woman being a homemaker. Simon wants to leave, however, as Gramsci's theory suggests. The state is composed of public institutions, including the government, court, police, and army, which exercises direct dominion. This prevents Simon from leaving. She is entrapped. The sense of entrapment is more subtle in Roma, shown through the inclusion of airplanes either in the mise-en-scene or the soundscape. This minute detail was added by Cuarón as planes served as a reminder of the larger world during Cuarón's childhood. Marx's theory states that ideologies are determined by class position. The little girl, having been born into a lower class family, is shown to be more religious. She has been molded into a set ideology. Nader's family, on the other hand, being in a higher class, have a range of ideologies, with Simon and Termes' progressive views connoted by her attire. This symbolism foreshadows the character's influences during the tale's conflict. Foreshadowing in Roma is also prevalent, most notably with the father, who has left behind a Galaxy car too big for the garage, stating the father's longing for more, having been replaced by something more fitting after his departure. The portrayal of the father isn't done so to make him villainous. Neorealism aims to challenge ideologies set by society. The hegemonic structure of society regarding marriage is that of entrapment, an unfair expectation towards people driven by religion, which Gramsci challenges, as he believes it is not that ideas are powerful enough to eliminate class struggle, but they are obviously capable of muting it sufficiently to allow class societies to function. Ferhadi stated in a 2011 interview with Filmmaker magazine that the mysterious, suspenseful nature of a separation was done in the editing phase of the film. Due to the long takes, great importance was created on when to cut in the action, which worked directly with the cinematography to shroud the tale in mystery. Cuarón too realized that the cuts would create the emotional beats that would have to be found in the edit. The often longer than normal, uncomfortable shot was done on purpose, as they often shot in ad-lib moments where the cut would be driven by the emotion. Those lingering shots, Cuarón stated, was to help audiences process the information due to there being a lack of artificial push through film techniques such as jump cuts or close-up angles. This is prominent in the scene where Cleo gives birth. Cesare Sabatini states that the first endeavor of a neorealist filmmaker was often to reduce the story to its most simple, elementary, and banal form. There's no particular emphasis on Hollywood editing to create artificial tension and audience manipulation, a common neorealist convention. This mindset is prevalent in the scene that has explained the cause of the conflict where Razia has been accused of stealing money. It was in fact Simon who took the money, however, there was no particular change in editing or soundscape, no gap between real life and what was on screen, as Zavattini put it, and thus seeming irrelevant, masked by the conversation between Simon and her daughter. Due to the Marxist ideologies placed upon the class, Nader is quick to blame the lower class, Razia, and Ferhadi has relied on foregrounding instead of transparency, a counter-cinema theory which would aid in the implementation of Zavattini's concept. The views and emotions of the characters, such as in Roma, are never highlighted through the dialogue, score, or subjective camera work. It is up to the viewers to derive the meaning. For example, Cleo's tears over the death of her child are later revealed to be tears of joy. The dominant representation of motherhood is that of being joyful, which is an underlying ideology. However, through the typical neorealist midshot, lacking any cuts, challenges viewer expectations. Cuarón wants to show the reality of his childhood and the troubled period of 1970s Mexico, lending itself to the neorealist genre. Similarly, the conflicted family dynamics of two people who are very much still in love, but due to different ideologies on what the future entails due to the interference of state, is an issue for Hadi does not try to glamorize. In fact, the very last scene shows the daughter, who throughout the movie is shown to be a victim of a conflict through the mise-en-scene, is torn between a life-changing decision, cutting before the decision is made, leaving it up to the viewer to determine the outcome based on personal ideology. Both films use differing social classes and their clashes to move the narrative forward, Roma utilizing a limited third-person perspective, while A Separation shows an objective view which plays a role in the narrative of the tale. The films allow for an audience to peer down into the troubled lives of the everyday people, ending with them looking forward, without any resolution into the uncertainty that the future entails. By both films' use of neorealist conventions in the representation of family dynamics being distraught by external factors, Ferhadi and Cuarón highlight the prosperity that a socialist society and the school of thought of Marxism would provide to the lives of the common man.